Our departure time is 1600. Get your bird started and I'll meet you on the runway.
Cobaletti, Colt, 1-1, request startup.
Colt 1-1, Colt 1-2, radio check. I only have one piece of advice. Do not lose sight of the target. Lose sight, lose the fight. I recommend you set up the air-to-air submenu and remove the A-10, F-15, and AH-64 references, and ensure the MI-8 hip is selected. This will make selecting the appropriate gun funnel easier and ensure your round land on the target. Remember, you want to place the wing rotor tips of the aircraft on the sides of the funnel to ensure proper angle and lead.
Pull up! Altitude!
Uncle Eddie. Colt, 1-1. Request taxi to runway. Cabaletti, Colt, 1-1, request takeoff.
Colt, 1-1, Cabaletti, you are cleared for takeoff and ready. Climb 300 at QFE 29.86.
Performance check starts now. Colt 1-1, Colt 1-2, fly heading 245, Angels 8, and maintain an appropriate speed. Hard deck limit is in effect. Do not go below Angels 5 unless the restriction is terminated. Approaching Angels 8. Level out and maintain appropriate speed. Good. Maintain 245, Angels 8, and appropriate speed. Use of the autopilot is authorized. Let's review the mission profile. Threat level is low, so this will be a high altitude profile. Your first two targets are at waypoint 5 and waypoint 6. Use your AIM-9s to take them out. The third and fourth targets are slow moving and at low altitude. They are located near waypoint 7 and waypoint 8. Use the gun on those targets. Good luck. Let's review the air-to-air training rules. Always assume the other aircraft does not see you. If each aircraft maneuvers in this manner, the chances of a mid-air are greatly reduced. Maintain 500 feet of separation at all times. Closure rates are often difficult to perceive, so no closer than 500 feet. For head-on passes, maintain the established trend. Never cross the bogey's flight path to force a change in the direction of pass. If in doubt, broadcast your own intentions. During descending pursuit, defensive aircraft monitors defensive aircraft's altitude and attitude, and breaks off the attack prior to either aircraft descending into the hard deck. The offensive aircraft in this case is flying out of the front of his aircraft and usually has a better SA and deck awareness. No blind lead turns. Do not pull so much lead pursuit so as to lose sight of the aircraft you are attacking. Remember, we are always assuming the other aircraft does not see us. Minimum range for gun attacks is 1,000 feet. Once again, closure rates may be hard to judge, and if you are too late to see it, it could be disastrous. Knock it off can be called by anyone, and all must acknowledge. See it first, call it. This could be due to a training rule violation, loss of SA, out of control flight, radio failure, bingo fuel, or any other dangerous situation. Nordo aircraft will rock his wings to indicate the radio failure. Colt 1-1, Colt 1-2. Turn right to 330, maintain Angels 8 and an appropriate speed. we will be maneuvering. We will do a G awareness test shortly after passing waypoint 2. Brevity code is G-warm. This is important in assessing your G proficiency and getting back your timing and execution of the anti-G straining maneuver. Checking G suit and combat edge connections and operation. Recalibrating how you apply on onset and control at peak level aircraft G. Providing an exposure to the cardiovascular system to activate its reflex response to a drop in blood pressure. A maneuver of 3 to 5 G for about 10 seconds is required to fully develop this reflex response. The maneuver is not performed in order to test how many G you can pull that day. Don't G-lock on the G-awareness turn. Remember your anti-G straining maneuver. Anticipate the G. Simultaneously tense all lower body muscles, legs, butt, and abdominal muscles. Deep breath with forced exhalation against a closed airway. Quick breath every 3 seconds, once at peak G. Minimize communications. Don't relax until the G is unloaded. Colt 1-1, Colt 1-2. Turn right to heading 065 and maintain Angels 8. Colt 1, Excel, G-warm. Colt 1, G-warm, 90 left, go. Colt 1, G warm, 90 right, go. Colt 1, fence in. Colt 1-2, fenced in, fuel, 4-3.
Colt 1-1, fence in.
SIF range control, Colt 1-2. Request clearance for Colt 1 flight of 2 A-10s west of entry Alpha. We have 4 AIM-9s and 2,000 rounds of 30 Mike Mike.
Colt 1-2, SIF range control, you are cleared at entry Alpha. You have the airspace from 500 to flight level 400. Weather is clear, visibility good in all quadrants. Authorized Colt 1-2 control.
Colt 1-2 confirms all altitudes, clear of clouds, hard deck 500. I have control. Let's review some information about the weapons you are using today. The Gao 8A is an excellent ground strafing weapon, but does not have the same rate of fire as the 20mm found in the F-15. Remember what it loses in quantity, it makes up for in quality. The kill capability of the 30mm round is higher, and it can penetrate the full length of a fighter aircraft. To get a good air-to-air gun kill, the target must be in range, be in the same plane of motion as your aircraft, and with your nose in late pursuit. Remember to use your gun funnel and the AMIL to assist in gun aiming. The AIM-9 Sidewinder is an infrared homing, short-range, all-aspect air-to-air missile. Navigates to predict a target collision point using a rocket motor with a burn time of about 5 seconds. It can attack from all directions, including head-on. The M model has an improved capability against infrared countermeasures. To get a good air-to-air AIM-9 kill, it is recommended you follow the 5 L's. Lock the missile on target, lead the target to ensure minimal angle for the missile to track. Look at the AIM-9 reticle, confirm it is tracking the target, and watch for countermeasures. Listen for a valid tone. Launch the missile and prepare to re-engage if necessary. The targets will be popping flares to help you VID them. Call Tally once you locate the target visually. You have permission to engage. If you cannot locate the targets, you are permitted to circle the target area and re-engage if required. Do not stray outside the target range or MOA. At the IP. Lights on.
Colt 1-1 in hot.
That's a kill. Let's head to the next waypoint for your next target.
Contact target, 11 o'clock. Point 13.
Colt 1-2, hostile.
Fox 2.
You damaged him, now finish him off.
Pull up! Pull up!
Guns! Guns! Guns!
That's a kill. Let's head to the next waypoint and see how you do against slow-moving targets. Colt 1-2, bogey.
Colt 1-1, tally.
Damaged him. Now finish him off.
Guns, guns, guns.
Pull up, pull up. Pull up, pull up. Altitude, altitude.
Guns, guns.
That's a kill. Let's head to the next waypoint for your next target.
Pull up, pull up. Pull up, pull up.
Code 1-2, hostile. Get him.
Colt 1-1, tally.
Pull up! Pull up!
Guns! Guns! Guns!
You damaged him. Now
guns! 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 Guns!
Pull up! Pull up!
Playtime is over. Time to head back to our egress point. Colt 1-2, off, safe, visual.
Altitude, altitude.
Colt 1-1, off.
SIF Range Control, Colt 1-2. Requesting clearance north of exit Bravo.
Colt 1-2, SIF Range Control, cleared for exit Bravo. Have a nice day.
Colt 1-2, roger. Cleared for exit Bravo. Now make your fence out call to alert the rest of the flight to do their fence out checks.
Colt 1-1, fence out.
Colt 1-2, fenced out 2-6. Hard deck restriction is terminated. You're permitted to land and shut down your bird. I'll give you a rating then.
Cabo Eddie, Colt 1-1, inbound.
Colt 1-1, Cabo Eddie, fly heading 166, Fort 1, QFE 29.86. Runway 25, to pattern altitude. Cabaletti, Colt 1-1, request landing. Colt 1-1, Cabaletti, clear to land, runway 25.
Altitude, altitude.
Take the taxiway to the right. You can park in the first free revetment on your left.
Congratulations. You passed this PO. You received a qualified Q rating. Well done. Return to Cobaletti for the next qualification mission.